Hello. Welcome back again. Good to see you. It's Halloween night and we're in the haunted forest. I'm on my own. Ben had a horrendous, absolutely horrendous week at work. Needs a bit of R&R, which is fair enough. So I'm on my own tonight. And I'll explain later why I have started the vlog in the smoky hut in the middle of the night when I chat to you later. I've just lit the outbacker tent's heating up nicely. Storm Aiden or Jimmy or Eric or whatever it's called, he's been a little bit tame at the minute. Certainly you can hear the wind through the pines, but we're expecting, or I'm expecting, a lot of heavy winds later on. Torrential rain, yellow warning for wind. But in the relative shelter of the forest, just at the foot of the low moorings, so shouldn't be too bad. What have we got here? Yeah, it's just heating up nicely. So a very quick look around camp. Corinthian Defence 4, X-Ped, bits and pieces, you know the drill. Yes. So, there's never been a Halloween that I have never been out in some shape or form. I'm going to do a stir fry here tonight because I'm famished, and maybe get a wee chat in with you around the campfire before the rain comes in, which I'm totally expecting to come in. So yes, at the moment Storm Aiden is reasonably calm, but I think he'll go out with a bang later on. I can certainly hear the wind. I don't know if you can, but I can certainly hear the wind around the tops of the pines there. Had a check round to make sure there was none that were about to fall down and kill me in the middle of the night, but not the most sensible thing to do in a gale, camp in a forest. Be very careful if you do that, or you get caught out in a gale and you're in a forest for shelter. Make sure that the trees that you're beside aren't uprooted or half-rooted or swaying, or common sense at the end of the day. So I'm going to prepare dinner here, which is a stir fry, one of Mickey Blue Eyes steaks. I'll chop it up and make a beef stir fry. So we'll get back to you shortly. So just putting the stir fry in. Put a sliced peppers, onions, celeries. Give it a good mix round. And then when these are cooked a bit better, and they're ready to, I'll mix it in. Way we do that, boys and girls. Oh, excuse me. That's looking good. Yep, we're getting there. Back to you shortly. That smells absolutely delicious. The wind is starting to get a bit silly now, so it is. So Storm Aiden is certainly, he's going to give me a good value tonight, I can imagine. But we'll see how it goes. I have a campfire lit just outside the smoky hut. And hopefully the rains don't start until their predicted time of just before midnight. But play it by ear. It's a moving picture every couple of minutes, but certainly the wind is starting to pick up. But we're nice and warm here in the smoky hut, warm and dry, and with the outbacker on, the ground actually starts to dry out. Everything inside just stays nice and dry, which is nice. There's none of that sort of. And the forest is very damp. I mean, I had some really, really, really surreal, almost torrential rain. The little babbling brooks became torrents, you know, coming down off mourns. But certainly the outbacker keeps everything nice and dry in a dampish sort of a forest, which is good. The outbacker tonight, more so for cooking and keeping everything dry, because it's not particularly cold, really, by any stretch of the imagination. So we're looking forward to the cold winter months coming in. I was actually justified to have the stove lit. Yeah, geez, I got that windows. The wind is certainly getting up. But relatively sheltered at the base of the trees. Oh, excuse me. Oops. Back in a bit when the dinner slides off the smoky hut, or off the outbacker. Those steak pieces are coming along rather nicely. Smell delicious. I suppose in anticipation of Storm Aiden with the yellow weather warning for wind, I have the smoky hut pegged out rather tight, like a long bag drum. So with torrential rain, should just slide off. I mean, I've had this out in pretty substantial rain before, and she's good in the rain. I don't have any worries about that there. And no matter what Storm Aiden throws at me, I think the smoky hut, because of the location where I am, sheltered the foot of the mourns in the forest with the pines, I think we'll get pretty good shelter from the severity of the storm. But yeah, it's always nice to get out, and if I time it nicely, I'll be able to have a sit around the campfire before the rains come in. And I'm sort of expecting the rains to come in about midnight or thereabouts, you know, according to the app. That's the Met Office app, which is a free download. I find it pretty accurate and pretty up to date, pretty good. Smells delicious. Yeah, so whatever Storm Aiden throws at me, I'll be warm. I'll be too warm. And I'll be dry. And I'll be comfortable, well fed. And that's the whole point. There's no point going out and making it a whole misery for yourself, you know, and being wet and cold and, you know. Is it glamping? It's not glamping at all. Just a little bit. It smells so good. So basically the meat is cooked to perfection, and what I'll just do is let it simmer, stir fry all those lovely peppers and celeries and veg in with it.
Lovely jubbly. Where would you get it? Where would you get it?
Reminds me of the time that when I first met Rob Hill from Falcon Outdoors Bushcraft Centre. Ben and I had pitched not that far from here. It was a Baltic night. And we could see lights, a couple of lights, at the top of the morn, making their way down the track. We had a fire going and we had dinner on the go. And lo and behold, it was Rob and Louise. And they come up beside us, introduced themselves. And I says, come on. There's plenty here for all of us. And that's how I met Rob. A pilgrim of the night and a good lad. Falcon Outdoors is his YouTube channel. So I would suggest you subscribe to it. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, and this is the sort of thing that you're interested in, then give me a like, and if you feel that you could subscribe, then it would be most appreciated. And yes, I have had a few wines. But anyway, it's Halloween night in the haunted forest. What could possibly go wrong? And there we have it, sirloin beef, chopped into little pieces, stir fry. Top it off with a little bit of jammy red roux from Yellowtail. Oh my word. Well, I'm going to horse this into me and I will see you shortly. Cheers. So here we are in the haunted forest on Halloween night. Cheers, and you're most welcome to my camp. Storm Aiden tonight, yellow weather warning for wind, lashings of rain and all that good natural stuff, but there's no storm that's going to prevent a pagan going out on Halloween night or Samhain. And to those of you who follow me, who are on the left-hand path, you'll know exactly what I mean. So it's a bit of a camp with a difference. The difference being the time of the year. And as I'm talking to you, I'm looking through the pines at a full moon. A full moon on Halloween night, Samhain. And there hasn't been a full moon on Samhain since, I think it's about 1943 or something out there. So it's a rather special evening tonight. Not so much about the camping and the glamping or whatever, but more on the spiritual side of the evening that is Samhain. To those of you who know me, will know that I am a pagan. And the path that I follow is the path of witchcraft. Immediately unsubscribe. Witchcraft has had a very bad press. It's always had a very bad press, but essentially, I'll put it to you that
Every wild camper who likes going into the forests, up into the mountains, by the lakes, to get their nature fix, are essentially witches who don't realize they're witches. Witchcraft essentially is a reverence of nature. We don't worship nature per se, but we see a divine, if you like, spirit within nature, within every living tree, within every bird, crow, squirrel, badger, fox, hare, deer. We feel a connection with that. And as such, we really do get our fix from being out in the woods, on a lonely mountaintop, beside a waterfall or lakeside. And for us pagans, it's essentially a fix for us to right ourselves with the wrongs of the world and the hub and bub of modern society. We take ourselves away from modern society and we commune, if you like, with nature. And on tonight, being Halloween, or Samhain as we like to call it, it's a very special occasion for us because it represents the time of the year when we go into darkness. The veil between this world and the other world is at its thinnest. We remember our ancestors and those who have left this mortal coil, if you like, have crossed over and are in the other world. And shortly I'll be performing a small ritual to honour those who have gone before us, our ancestors, our dearly departed, who will never be forgotten. Those candles will be lit on their birthdays. And when we hear their names mentioned, we get that lovely glow inside of the person who they were, the memories of that person. And it's a time for witches and pagans to celebrate the ancestors, the recently departed, and remember them with joy and love. And it gives us a sense of belonging to something that is way, way, way beyond the human condition, if you like. Halloween is essentially very, very Celtic Irish tradition. It was basically born in Ireland, the ancestral remembrances, the traditions are all steeped in our Irish Celtic past. Now you might think that Halloween is a big thing in America, but trust me, it it all started in Ireland. And there's been a lot of traditions associated with Samhain. The murmurs, the dressing up at Halloween, which is basically to ward off the pooka, the fae, who come out this time of the year and wish to take us from our mortal existence into the other world. And so dressing up as goblins and witches and other strange beings of the night, the hope is that when the pooka and the fae see someone dressed as a witch or some sort of entity, that they will leave them aside. Well, I always think that's a really nice tradition, and it's certainly one that has followed on from the centuries to today, where people dress up as witches and various other ghoulies and goblins of the night, etc., etc. And certainly it's a nice tradition to keep and to maintain. In a society today where everything is laptops and computers and smartphones, and it's just nice to get away from the modernity of life, to go back into our Celtic pagan past and celebrate the things that still resonate with all of us in some shape or form, some more so than others. So on this Halloween night, the haunted forest belongs to me, for the simple reason that the demons and the fae and the pooka, in the presence of a witch, they do fear to tread. And I have no fear and no foreboding and no intrepidation of the night that is ahead of me. Even though I'm here on a full moon in a haunted forest on Samhain, Halloween as you call it, I fear no evil, because there is no evil. Evil is a manifestation of your own mind. And once you connect with nature and the forests and the waterfalls and the rivers and the seas and the oceans and the mountains, there is no fear. There is no fear. So quite a different vlog tonight. Certainly because of the season that's in it. And I would like to wish you and all your loved ones a very happy Samhain for Halloween. And I hope and pray that the departure of your loved ones and your recent bereavements, you can take succor in the fact that they are watching over you. They haven't really left you. They have crossed over to a plane that we don't fully understand, but safe in the knowledge that they are there looking over you. And it's always poignant, and certainly at this time of the year, it's our tradition to remember our loved ones, our recently departed loved ones, to think about the good times we had with them, time shared, jokes laughed at, and remember who they were and the contribution that they made to make your life that little bit better. So I raise a glass, or in this case a cooksa, to all the dearly departed, our loved ones, you are never forgotten. and we speak your names over the fire, and you are never forgotten. Hail and farewell. So as I say, it's a bit of a different ramble tonight, and basically it's that connection that we feel with nature that drives us into the woods, into the lonely places in the mountains, and by the riversides and waterfalls and lakes, where we all connect. We all have that reverence and connection with nature. And I put it to you, you're all pagans. All our ancestors were pagans. Before St. Patrick came over and messed it all up for everybody, if you like. We were all pagans. We all had that connection, that deep, deep connection with nature. And as a wild camper, I am able to go into the dark woods on Halloween night, the scariest night of the year, if you like, and fear no evil. Evil is only the manifestation of your own fears. You connect with the trees, with the mountains, and with the moon tonight, which is peeping through as I speak. So it's a beautiful sight. So on that note, I'll wish us all happy Samhain. And hopefully the memories that you have of your loved ones who have crossed over are good ones. And that you light a little candle on their birthdays. So thank you. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you in the morning for breakfast. Thanks very much. God bless. And I'll see you in the morning.
On this solemn eve, we give thanks for the harvest and the abundance of the earth. As we enter the season of darkness, we remember those who have crossed over. And on a night like tonight, All Hallows Eve, when the veil between this world and the other world is at its thinnest, we remember those who have gone before us. We state their names: Tom Fleming, Bob Wilson, Peggy Ryan, Jim Morrison, Jez Lilly. May your memories be a blessing to us all.
So, the wind is howling. I don't know if you can hear it or not. The wind is howling and we're expecting really torrential rain later. So, I'm going to retire for the evening. It's lovely and warm in here. Absolutely roasting. I'll be stripping off me before I go to bed. Have a cup of tea before bedtime. So I'll bid you good night, and I'll see you in the morning. And I'll switch all the lights off, switch the tilly light off, and I'll just listen to the wind racing through the tops of the pines. And if anything strange or supernatural or otherwise of interest happens throughout the night, I shall try and record it. But anyway, good night, and I'll see you in the morning. Morning, 4 a.m., and Storm Aiden has, I assume, reached his peak. The trees are really, really roaring with the wind. I'm sure you're going to hear the rain on the tent. I just had a quick look round and make sure everything's tied down, which it is. There's no leaks. Sitting here snug as a bug. I'm not even in the sleeping bag, I just use it as a duvet. I just thought I would give you an update. It's actually the winds that woke me up, so
I think I'll have a coffee while I'm up. That'll keep me up. I don't know. I'll maybe try and get away, get another few hours sleep. I slept soundly. I went to bed just after midnight. Those four, just over 4 hours, solid sleep. Till the wind woke me. I'd like to hear the peaceful sound of the wind howling in the pines and the rain tapping off the tent. It's a rough day out there, folks. It is a rough one. Getting a wee bit of battering about in the wind, but not for that. Sheltered in the forest. As long as a tree doesn't fall on me, I'll be alright.
Good morning, glampers and campers. Bit of a stormy one last night for sure. One stage I had to get out and make sure she was pegged down securely. She took a bit of a battering last night, especially in the rain. But she didn't leak. It was nice and dry inside, and as I just let the outbacker stove slowly burn away, just provided nice heat for the rest of the night. Didn't even get into the sleeping bag, just used it as a duvet. But it's a fresh morning, the sun is out. I'm going to light the outbacker now and get breakfast on. I'll give you a quick look around camp. So, wee bit of a wood supply there. I don't know how much you're going to see in this light. Oh, I've breakfast already prepared. Bacon and eggs, tomato and mushroom, coffee to go. Old Faithful X-Ped, comfy mat, Cedar Summit pillow, wee canvas ex-Dutch Army bag, good for carrying bits and pieces. Snug pack Bergen, some camera gear bag, a bag with some camera gear. And the good old Corinthia Defence 4. Great bag. Ah, it's just a wee cheap tarp underneath. But once this bad boy is lit, I'm hoping to get the... excuse me. I'm hoping to get the smoky hut dried out a bit. She's a bit wet, all right. But 20 minutes of the outbacker on, and she'll be good to go. So still all pegged out. Had to put the extra guy lines out because of the storm. Kaiser Burr was asking about the stove jack. It's just a wee homemade stove jack with bacon sheets, oven sheets. Just cut them out. There's a wee aperture already in the smoky hut. I just cut them out and velcroed them down on both sides, and you just make a wee sort of a hole there, just enough to push the flue through. It doesn't touch the sides of the tent at all. So yeah, I'm going to get the outbacker on now. Get everything warmed up, dried out. Well, everything is dry, but you know what I mean. The outside of the skin of the tent, see if I can get it dried out a bit. So I'll get back shortly. Well, that's another one over. Thanks very much for coming along. I had to strike camp pretty sharpish. It's starting to chuck down. So I made the 3.5 mile trek with all that gear back up to the car. Just in the nick of time too, because it is, it'll pop you out. Have a look. I think Aiden is coming for a part two. But yeah, so thought I'd pull over here and just wind up the video, just to thank us for coming along, and hope you enjoyed it. Wee bit of a twist to it, I suppose. For those of you who know me, it's all par for the course, but hopefully not put any new subscribers off from subscribing. If you like it, hit a like. If you disliked it, hit the dislike button twice. But anyway, thanks very much for your support, and we'll certainly see you on the next one, which I'm hoping to get up the coast at some stage, maybe. But we'll see how that goes. The lakeside is also due a touch, but I miss the coast. I miss Kinbeyan Head. It's just a pity it's all blocked off. But there's another couple of spots up around the coast there that should be available. So as long as there's no more Storm Aidens or Ginnies or Jemimas, it'll be grand. Yes, it's a bit of a glamp taking all that gear down the mountain and then through the forest. It's a big weight penalty, but it keeps you fit, I suppose. Anyway, thanks very much. Look after yourselves, look after each other. I'll catch you on the next one.